Fritz the Cat, Fritz the Cat, Fritz the Cat. Oh my word, this movie. A film with an incredible legacy and a passionate following. But what makes this film so iconic, so memorable, and to this day continues to inspire and influence? That is what I'll be discussing today. In Fritz the Cat, a classical masterpiece? Before coming to life on the big screen, Fritz the Cat was brought to life as a comic book character created by Robert Crumb. Many of Fritz's characteristics can be found right here, his egotistical ways as well as his love of sex and drugs. Ralph Bakshi found out about Fritz and looked to turn Fritz the Cat into an animated feature. For those of you that don't know, Bakshi is an absolute legend in the animated world, with films such as Wizards, Coonskin and Heavy Traffic. He also brought The Lord of the Rings to life, and I actually have a video about that on my channel that you guys can go and watch. Bakshi faced a ton of uphill battles to bring Fritz to the big screen, from arguments with Crumb over the rights of Fritz, to even finding funds and distribution from production companies. No one wanted to fund an animated feature film full of sex and drugs. Remember, up until this time, animation was exclusively for children and families. This was unlike anything we had ever seen before. Luckily, Cinemation Industries came to the rescue and the film had funding. But before the film was even released, it faced controversy. But not just from moviegoers, but even animators who didn't really want to illustrate some of the scenes that were going on in the film. And so there was no surprise when the tagline, "He's X-rated and animated," was used. So in 1972, the film was finally released and it was a smash hit. It became one of the highest grossing independent animated features of all time. It's actually incredible that Fritz the Cat was not only released, but that it was so successful. But of course, the film was not without controversy. In fact, Fritz's creator Crumb hated the movie so much that he even killed Fritz off in the comic. He even sued to have his name removed and taken off the film. But still, people loved the movie and went to watch it in droves. So we spoke about the film's production, now let's actually talk about the film itself. Fritz the Cat is, of course, an X-rated adult animated comedy film. The story follows the main character Fritz, a college student who longs to be a writer and has quite the appetite for sex and drugs. Honestly, to sum up Fritz, he thinks he is some incredibly smooth-talking wise philosopher who knows better than everyone. But in reality, he's an egotistical idiot. He's just a jerk, actually. He's incredibly unlikable. In regards to plot, the film is divided into three thirds, and these actually feel like three episodes of a television series that have been pushed together into one film. Or rather, three short stories that have been placed in one book. A good example of what this feels like is that weird sequel to Atlantis. The first third episode chapter introduces us to Fritz as he tries to have sex with three girls and ends up being chased by the police. The second follows Fritz as he tries to adapt to the lifestyle of the crows and starts a riot. And the third, he gets caught up with a bunch of Nazis. So the movie tends to jump from scene to scene and location to location, but never do these locations feel stale. The movie starts off in your more typical locations, the parks and apartment buildings, but then starts to venture out into bars full of crows, deserts, cemeteries, and even synagogues. And of course, if you haven't noticed, the characters are animals. And this movie takes us in some creative and symbolic ways. African Americans are portrayed as crows, and police are pigs. The film leans heavily into political and social aspects of life at the time, and you can definitely see how the problems of the time have influenced the film. Aspects such as racism, police brutality, drugs, and hippies are all front and center here, and so the film has a lot to say and show. But if you take all that away and just look at the film by itself, in isolation from the messages it portrays, unfortunately, it's just a movie that isn't too good. And the biggest reason for this is probably the main character, Fritz. And that's simply because of how unlikable he is. He's an egotistical jerk and we've got to follow him throughout the whole movie. Because of his selfish ways, it made it incredibly hard for me to care about him and what he got invested with. I wasn't supporting him and I couldn't care less about how he turned up at the end of the movie. But that's not to say there are no characters to get invested in and enjoy. While most characters are also shallow and boring, you do get a few that stand out. To a lesser degree, you can see this in Blue, the heroin-addicted Nazi rabbit who has one of the coolest character introductions of all time. And to a greater degree, you can invest in Duke the Crow and Harriet, who is apparently a horse? Duke is probably the closest thing that Fritz has to a friend in this movie. He defends him in bars, exposes him to crow culture, and even saves his life. But it is Fritz's own desire that causes the tragic and brutal killing of Duke by the hands of the brutal police force. Harriet is by far the most sympathetic of all the characters in the movie, as she seems like she is a genuinely nice and caring character who was in an abusive relationship. And we see this firsthand in an incredibly, incredibly disturbing scene where she is beaten with a chain and then raped. So at the end of the day, can I recommend Fritz the Cat as a must-see movie? Well, it's complicated. I enjoy Fritz the Cat because of its social and political commentary and what it has to say. But the quality of the characters and scripts leave an awful lot to be desired. The movie's incredibly dark tone and subject matter definitely won't be for everyone. But this is an incredibly impressive movie, with what it was able to accomplish when it came out, and the fact that we are still feeling the influences of this film in films being released today are proof of its importance.